Starting off this countdown, we have Miss Bell. For weeks, a man named Alan Smith was haunted by a pale figure of a woman in his mansion. Apparently, this woman would lurk around the hallways and in the bedrooms around 1 o'clock in the morning. She could be seen surrounded by a blue haze and just drifted around the house. Then one day, he found a painting in his house and realized that the woman in the painting was the woman who was haunting him. After doing research, he discovered that the ghost was of a woman named Miss Bell. She used to live in the mansion. But apparently, she went bankrupt and lost all of her possessions. Well, Alan ended up hanging the painting in his home, and ever since then, the haunting stopped. Miss Bell seemed to be at peace. But it's said that no one else can own the painting except the mansion's owner. If the painting ever leaves the premise, Miss Bell will arise again and haunt those until her painting is returned to its proper location. Moving on to number 9, we have the Dead Mother. You may not have heard of this painting by Edvard Munch, but chances are you have seen his famous piece of artwork. Now, this painting is quite dark. It depicts a dead mother laying on her bed while her child stands there covering her ears. This painting is said to represent the devastation that Scandinavia faced due to tuberculosis. Just when you thought the painting couldn't get any worse, it's said that the eyes of the child in the painting will follow you. Others say that they have heard the rustle of the bed sheets from the photo and have heard the mother cough. Others claim that they have seen the mother change positions, or that they've seen the child move, blink, or even disappear from the painting entirely. The painting is for sure cursed. What else could explain this? Coming in at number 8, we have the Roque B. Venus. The Roque B. Venus, otherwise known as Venus at Her Mirror or the Toilet of Venus, is a beautiful painting created in 1658. The painting features a half-naked woman, Venus, staring at herself in a mirror that Cupid is holding. This is actually a lovely painting, but it's said to bring sickness and death to whoever owns it. One woman died mysteriously while the painting was in her family's possession. Other owners were murdered. As a result, no museum or hotel or other place ever wants to own it. Then in 1914, a British female rights activist sliced the painting with a butcher's knife. She did this because she was disgusted by how men were staring at her body all day long. So she took a meat cleaver and sliced it. But rumor has it that the canvas barely got a scratch. Only if you look very close at the painting can you see the slash marks. It's thought that the painting is so strong that not even a physical object can stop it. Moving on to number 7, we have the Witch Girl. Now, I couldn't find much information on this painting. It features a picture of a girl crying, but I don't know who painted it or even the year it was created. All that's said about it is that it's a painting of a witch child, and apparently it's very haunted. So it's said that the painting once belonged to a Spanish man who felt like the girl's eyes in the painting would follow him. He also said that at night a gray silhouette would appear right by the canvas. In fact, many people are convinced that the specter is Madame Delphine LaLaurie herself. LaLaurie was known for torturing her slaves in very, very gruesome ways. But now my question is, why is she haunting this painting? And is it really her? In our 6th spot, we have the Stagecoach painting. So this painting has a very dark and twisted backstory, so no wonder it's cursed. So in 1994, a photographer named James Kidd took a bunch of photos of stagecoaches in Tombstone, Arizona. However, upon developing the photos, he realized that there was a ghost of a headless man standing on a log beside the stagecoach. And then a painter thought it would be a good idea to recreate this photo as an oil painting. And as a result, that ghost attached itself to the painting. Seriously, what did she expect? So when the painting was complete, it was hung out of business. But a couple of days later, the business demanded that she take it back. Apparently, the painting was found crooked every morning, despite them constantly correcting it. They also blamed the painting for paperwork going missing and appointments getting messed up. The painting was just bringing them immense bad luck. Then, when she brought it back home, she started experiencing bad luck herself. Her garage roof started leaking, but roofers couldn't find the source of the leak. And when the painting was moved, the leak stopped. On top of that, things would break on their own and she would hear weird ghostly noises. We're now at our fifth and halfway mark with Bernardo de Galvez. This painting is said to be one of the most haunted paintings in the world. So the painting is a portrait of Bernardo de Galvez, a very powerful Spanish military leader. In the early 1900s, the city of Galveston opened a hotel named after him, and in the hotel they hung this massive portrait of him. But it seems as if Bernardo has attached himself to his portrait. A lot of guests have seen his ghost wandering the halls by his portrait. Others complained about feeling very unsettled while passing by the painting. In fact, a lot of people have reported feeling cold and uneasy when standing close to the portrait. Also, on a number of occasions, if you try to take a photo of the portrait, it will end up coming out blurry or completely dark. So the hotel truly believes that the painting is cursed by Bernardo himself. In our fourth spot, we have Maria Lopukhina. This is a portrait of Maria Lopukhina, a young Russian woman who sadly died of tuberculosis. The painting was made in 1797, a few years before her passing, and now it's said that her restless soul haunts the painting. In fact, it's so cursed that bad luck will fall on whoever looks directly at the painting. It was said that the painting contains some kind of power that can cause healthy young girls to die randomly. In fact, this has happened so often that people are convinced that the portrait actually steals the souls of the girls and traps them inside the painting. In our third spot, we have the suicide girl. Looking at this painting, you wouldn't think there'd be anything to be afraid of. Just wait. So story goes that a girl committed suicide shortly after creating this image. She drew the picture, scanned it, posted it online, and then she took her own life. Now, legend goes that if you stare into the girl's eyes for too long, then she will get you to take your own life as well. Some that have stared at it for a while have claimed that the portrait turns evil. The girl gets an evil smirk on her face and dark circles appear under her eyes. In our second spot, we have Man Proposes, God Disposes. Painted in 1864 by Edwin Henry Landseer, this painting was inspired by Sir John Franklin's expedition in 1845, when they disappeared without a trace. This painting is how Edwin imagined their fate would be, but little did he know that he created an extremely cursed painting. So this painting is hung up in the exam hall at Royal Holloway University of London. Rumor has it that in the 1970s, a student committed suicide after staring at the painting. All he left behind was a note that read, "The polar bears made me do it." Other students have said that they felt uneasy while sitting next to it. As a result, students purposely go out of their way to avoid this painting, and the university has to cover it up while students are taking tests. And in our number one spot, we have The Anguished Man. This has to be by far the most haunted painting in the world. So story goes that a man named Sean Robinson inherited the painting from his grandmother. The artist of the painting still remains unknown, but it's said that he mixed his own blood with the paint. They ended up killing themselves shortly after finishing the painting. Sean's grandmother was convinced that this painting was haunted. She would hear screaming or crying coming from the painting, and she would often see a shadowy figure by it. As a result, she kept it locked away in her attic. They believed that it was haunted by the ghost of the artist. When Sean inherited the painting, bad things started to happen to him and his family. His son was pushed down the stairs by the ghost, his wife felt someone stroking her hair, and a shadow would lurk through the halls. To this day, Sean keeps the painting locked up in a secure location. It said, "It's far too dangerous for anyone to own." Starting off this countdown, we have Ivan the Terrible and his son Ivan, aka my dad and brother. Just kidding, because my last name's Ivan, so it would be Mr. Ivan. And anyway, this painting was created by a Russian realist painter, Ilya Repin. This picture depicts Ivan the Terrible holding his terribly wounded son after he injured him during a fight. You can see the terrified look on his face as his son bleeds to death in his arms. Well, apparently while creating this piece, Repin fell into depression, and then a rumor went around saying that the painting was cursed. In fact, a man named Baram Balashov was driven mad by looking at the painting. He freaked out and yelled, "Stop the bloodshed!" Then he was taken to the psychiatric hospital. Others have had bad anxiety attacks and paranoia while staring at it. Moving on number 9, we have the Repin Curse. Ilya Repin is back at it again, creating more cursed pieces of art. Honestly, it's said that he was cursed, and everyone that posed for his paintings later fell sick and died mysteriously. This is what happened to 3 men in the painting The Barge Haulers. They were all healthy men before posing for the photo. After it, they slowly died off one by one by unnatural causes. So it's said that this painting and many others of Repin's are cursed. In our 8th spot, we have Love Letters. With a name like that, you would think it'd be like a cute romantic painting, right? Well, not so much. This painting is of a creepy little girl in a pink dress, smiling while holding a bunch of pink roses. Apparently, the girl in the painting was a real girl, but sadly fell to her death after chasing her ball down some stairs. The painting was created in her memory and hung in the Drizkill Hotel, the place that she passed away. But hold on a second, this painting is literally in the Drizkill Hotel, and it's cursed? Coincidence? I think not. Guests of the hotel have claimed to feel dizzy and nauseous while around the painting. Others have claimed that they have felt as if they were being lifted off of the ground, or have even seen the girl change expressions. Now, some people own some replicas of this piece of art, and they too have felt dizzy and nauseous around it. So it doesn't matter which version you own, whether it's the original or a replica. All versions are cursed. In our 7th spot, we have Teresa Rover. In November of 2005, an Italian TV show called The Voyager was filming a self-proclaimed psychic named Gustavo Roll. Well, in the show, they captured footage of a painting hanging in their home. The painting was of a noble lady, Teresa Rover. Now, in real life, Teresa is frowning in the painting, but when the TV show captured it, it looked like her mouth was curling upwards in a sinister smile. People went on to then say that the painting is cursed by the ghost of Teresa. Moving on, number 6, we have Isabel Duendi. Honestly, just by looking at this painting, you know it's cursed. It honestly gives me the creeps. So this painting is of a young girl named Isabel Duendi. We don't know much about it, but the artist describes her as being a dead young girl. The description of the painting reads as follows. With the heel of her hand, Isabel Duendi, dumb as a skid of bricks, raked all of the tiny shells from the lip of the shelf into her gaping yawn, and they were swallowed darkly while Isabel's black eyes rolled back into the ocean of her head. Alas, dear reader, she was dead. Yeah, that's creepy, but hey, if you want to buy this painting, it's currently on sale for $355 US, so anyone looking to get cursed? Now's your chance. We are now at our 5th and halfway mark with Saturn Devouring His Son. Doesn't that sound like a pleasant name for a painting? Well, it's a pretty gruesome painting, but it was actually considered one of the greatest paintings of the 19th century. Probably the most cursed too. Anyway, it was painted by a man named Francisco Goya, who was inspired by the Greek myth, where Saturn eats all of his sons with fear that they will overthrow him. A lot of people claim that this painting is cursed. They feel sick looking at it. And in one case, a woman actually passed out after having a panic attack from it. Moving on to number 4, we have Pogo the Clown. This painting is disturbing for a number of reasons. The main one being that it was painted by serial killer John Wayne Gacy while he was on death row. John Wayne Gacy was an American serial killer who murdered 33 boys and young men in the 1970s. He was given the nickname the Killer Clown because he would dress up as Pogo the Clown for neighborhood events or children's parties. And so this painting is of John dressed up as Pogo the Clown. And it's such a creepy painting once you know its backstory. Like, John Gacy was anything but a fun party clown. I mean, clowns are scary in general, but this makes it that much more terrifying. In our 3rd spot, we have Kohada Kohiji. I'm hoping I pronounced that right, okay? I apologize if I didn't. Well, there's a whole legend surrounding this one painting. So Kohada was an actor back in the 1700s. One day he found out that his wife was having an affair. The wife and secret, not so secret lover then killed him to keep it a secret. But Kohada came back as a ghost and haunted them for years, eventually killing the wife and driving the lover insane until he killed himself. Now it's said that he haunts all depictions of himself, whether it be paintings of him or adaptions of his story. In fact, actors that have performed his story have been hurt in suspicious accidents. They blame it on the ghost of Quijada. Moving on, number two, we have The Hands Resist Him. This is said to be one of the most haunted paintings in America. So this painting was created by an artist named Bill Stoneham in 1972. It's of a young boy and female doll standing in front of a glass panel door, and that has these like creepy ghost child hands like pressed on it, and the girl is creepy as heck with hollow dark eyes and a sad face. Now, according to the history of the painting, it was purchased and sold multiple times by different people. Why? Because it's cursed, no one wants to own it. In 2000, it appeared on eBay by someone trying to get rid of it, claiming it was haunted. According to the seller, their daughter said the boy and the doll in the picture would fight each other at night. So they ended up setting up a motion sensing camera for 3 nights, just monitoring the painting. And it captured the boy leaving the frame. Some people that have seen the painting have said it made them feel ill or dizzy. One person even said they heard an exorcist type voice after viewing the painting. But children are the ones most affected by the painting, and it will haunt them in their dreams. And in our number one spot, we have The Weeping Children. The Weeping Children are a collection of paintings created by a man named Giovanni Bragolin. Every painting in this collection depicts either little boys or girls crying. And it's said that whoever owns any of these paintings will face tragedy. Yeah, so it isn't just one of his paintings that were cursed. It was all of them. In fact, a string of house fires were all thought to have been caused by these paintings. All of the houses that caught on fire were completely destroyed, except for the paintings that remained perfectly undamaged. In fact, people have tried to burn the paintings and found that they are impossible.
From where the fire had touched it, but the flames hadn't spread.
But you'd have to say that fire's pretty much going out.
Martin, though, was a man of science and not given to superstition.
There's this one story of a poor couple named Ron and May Hall that owned one of these paintings. Their house unexpectedly caught on fire and they lost almost everything, except for the painting of a crying boy that wasn't even blackened by the smoke. Pretty creepy.
Filling our number 7 slot is The Rain Woman. The painting was done by Ukrainian artist Svetlana Telets, who said the piece took her a total of 5 hours to make, which I feel is like a record time for an artist. She'd never completed a painting that fast, but felt like her hand was being guided by someone else the entire time. The painting itself kind of looks like a creepy, narrow caricature of the woman and the woman in black, and after she finished painting it, it was sold numerous times, but the owners kept returning it almost immediately because they all reported feelings of fear, insomnia, unexplained sadness, anxiety, and the feeling that they were being watched all the time if they were near the painting. I mean, if you're an artist and you finish a great painting in 5 hours and you claim your hand wasn't even moving itself, the likelihood of that painting ending up screwed up is high, which is why I'm not surprised it screwed with every owner that it had. Now at number 6 is The Dead Mother. I love how melancholy yet straight to the point these titles are. Many of you will know the Scream painting, but it was Edvard Munch's Dead Mother painting that really got people's attention. The disturbing picture depicts a little girl standing with her hands on her ears in front of her mother's dead body. The painting has been displayed at countless art exhibitions around the world, and many have claimed the girl's eyes incessantly follow them and that the child moves, blinks, and sometimes leaves the painting entirely. Others have even said they've heard the bed sheets of the mother's bed rustling and seen the mother switch positions. I mean, I don't know how much I believe in a painting moving to that degree, but the masses have spoken. Filling our number 3 slot is The Untitled Painting. Zbigniew Beksiński was a Polish painter who liked painting in the style of dystopian surrealism. His paintings were mostly gothic or baroque, and he never gave any of them a title. Honestly, his paintings look like hallucinations from hell or something you'd see while lucid dreaming, but they're incredible. Weirdly enough, he burned many of his paintings in his backyard before even showing them to anyone. Beksiński's life was full of tragedy. His wife died in 1998, and a year later on Christmas Eve, his son committed suicide and he found his body. Then in 2005, he was found murdered in his apartment with 17 stab wounds because he refused to give $100 to Robert Kupek, the son of his longtime caretaker. So the man really had a trouble life till the end, and many believe if you look at his paintings for too long, you'll face your own death soon after that. Also, can we just congratulate me for actually saying his name correctly? Polish subscribers, did I say his name correctly or not? Please support me. Starting us off with number 10 is Madame La Laurie. Honestly, this hoe finds herself in every video, I swear to God. But anyway, we should all know who she is by now, the New Orleans socialite that tortured and mutilated almost all of her slaves. Well, long after Delphine fled her mansion on Royal Street, sometime in the 70s, major renovations were underway to turn it into luxury apartments. In 1997, the new owners thought it would be a great idea to get a portrait made of Madame La Laurie because she was such a wonderful person, why not remember her forever? Not. Once the painting was placed inside the building, everything started going wrong. Many believe a certain darkness attached itself to the painting, or perhaps it was the dark soul of the woman herself. The painting would move on the wall by itself, it would rock so much that the canvas would free itself from the frame. People living there said they felt unnerved anytime they were near the portrait, and almost all of them used to hear echoes of voices, cold touches on their skin, and the smell of smoke. Just a side note, the reason Madame La Laurie fled is because her mansion had a huge house fire, so that's where the smell of smoke makes sense here. Residents had items go missing, one even said the painting talked to her and footsteps would follow her around her apartment. Clothes would get bundled in the fireplace but not burn, carpenters would see a grey lady appear out of nowhere. After countless paranormal reports, the owners finally returned the portrait to the original artist. Now at number 6 is the unknown painting. While the title is unknown, the artist is the famous Yuko Tatsushima. Yuko is an artist and performer, yet her talents lend themselves quite well to paranormal and supernatural purposes. Most of her work is provocative and just quite unsettling to look at. The particular picture I'm talking about depicts a black and red scratched background with a woman, I mean I want to say woman but really it's more of a thing, in the middle. The eyes are massive, they're not human-like, and its neck is quite long. I mean there's nothing really sinister about the painting despite it being creepy, and the thing is smiling, right? I mean, there's that. But I don't know if that's a smiling through the pain smile or I'm gonna kill you smile. The painting is quite cursed, and that's also a well-known fact. It's meant to induce feelings of suicide on those who look at it. Coming in at number 5 is the Lady Ossington. Viscountess Ossington built the Coffee Palace located on Beast Market Hill back in 1882. She built it for the good of society, and it was aimed at travellers who wanted a place to stay without the temptation of alcohol on the premise. Lady Ossington managed the establishment till her death and was meant to be succeeded by her trustees, who would continue her crusade against the demon drink. Honestly, I feel like she probably got way too drunk one night and was like, I'm never drinking again, ended up being the only person in the world ever actually sticking to that. But anyway, moving on, by the 60s, a court decided the Coffee Palace wasn't as charitable as advertised, since Lady Ossington's heirs were the real beneficiaries of the Coffee Palace, so they were like, that's not on, and sold the place. Inside the Coffee Palace, however, hung an oil portrait of Lady Ossington herself, which many believe is cursed and haunted by the woman. It's said that after the place was sold, the portrait started flying off the wall, mimicking Lady Ossington's disgust over what happened to her business. And finally, at number 1 is The Faceless Women. Again, that's not the title of the painting, I just gave it the title based on what it is, but it was painted by Carrigan. Carrigan's an online user of Feasters who mostly paints pieces involving Yuri-style bondegado, which is basically just a fancy term that means lesbian bondage. Now, the painting depicts 4 girls, a blonde girl in the middle with rope around her mouth and décolletage, and surrounding her are 3 other girls, with the one right behind her having her hand on the middle girl's head, whilst the other 2 on either side of her have 1 hand each on the middle girl's neck, kind of like a power move. But the creepy thing about the 3 women is that they have no faces, they have black hollows for eyes, but then no nose, no mouth, no nothing. It's like they're all wearing white masks almost. Carrigan made up a fictional story to go along with the painting, but many say they simply can't stand looking at it. There's something unnerving about it that irks everyone who sees it, which really makes no sense because it's not even based on a real person. I mean, there's no spirit or soul cursing it, and yet it's cursed. The artists themselves said they had trouble finishing the piece, citing feelings of anxiety, suicidal thoughts, and paranoia. But hey, at least you did it in the end.
At number 10, The Face of War, from 1941, by Salvador Dali. The Spanish Civil War and the Second World War were likely influences in Dali's painting. There are skulls in increasing states of decay further into the painting you go. The snakes writhe around the tormented face. The whole painting is done in a muted tone of browns, nearly lacking the liveliness of color, except for the hopeful bit of blue sky in the background. And in his diary, Dali wrote that the anguish of death was one of the most energetic motors that make the artistic and superfine brain of Salvador Dali function. He also wrote, "Not a single minute of my life passes without the sublime Catholic, apostolic, and Roman specter of death accompanying me, even in the least important of my most subtle and capricious fantasies." Wow. People have remarked at the handprint in the lower right corner, but what about the one in the upper right corner? This painting in total just has a lot going on, and ultimately, I find it both intriguing and horrifying to look at, just like the decaying skulls and everything. At number 9, The Nightmare, from 1781 by Henry Fuseli. If you have sleep paralysis, watch out. This one might feel a little too familiar. A dark presence resting on your chest is a feeling that this painting kind of reflects, in my opinion. There is an ape-like, impish figure that sits on a lady's chest while she is bathed in a white light, lying down and hanging off the bed, and the creature bores its eyes into the people viewing the art. And don't forget about the dark horse head that's peering through the curtains. This one is one that makes me want to check and see if anything is lurking in my room before I pass out asleep, but my room is too messy for that, sorry mom. So this one kind of gives that creepy, sleepy vibe. But on to number 8, Inheritance, from 1897 by Edvard Munch. You may know Munch's name from his famous work, The Scream, which is like, and his work in Expressionism. Also, people talk about his work, The Dead Mother, being haunted, just like Ama did in her video on cursed paintings. But right now, I'm talking about his work, Inheritance. It appears to be a woman crying over her child, but we can tell something isn't right. Healthy children have more substance than this, and the head-to-body ratio is off. The baby, to me, looks a little alien, and there's yellowed skin and some blood splatter. To me, it looks like a young and pained version of the Scream, which isn't, of course, the right interpretation or the real one, because truly what this painting is about is the horrors of syphilis, a commonly transmitted STD. It was a bit of a taboo at the time to depict in art, so it caused quite a stir in society, which kind of is what you hope art can do, raise awareness. But scary to look at, nonetheless. On to number 7. The Sleep by Vincent Castiglia at number 7, made in 2006. This man's main medium is blood on paper, and he goes into it on his website, saying his pieces are painted with what could be thought of as liquid flesh, and in this way, the subject's realism is not merely an optical illusion due to its level of detail, but rather an actual transference of flesh and blood to each work. And so, haunting is a good way to describe Castiglia's highly realistic monochrome works, because for sure, even more so creepy when you find out he siphons his own blood in his studio, and he's trying to divide the barrier between artist and art, literally putting himself into his work, so he's currently still making things, so get a piece of him while you can get it, I guess. And he's talking about life, death, the human condition, really gets your mind going. A lot of creepy pieces, check it out if you're into that. But on to number 4, Saturn, Jupiter's father, devours one of his sons. Made in the years 1636 to 1638 by Peter Paul Rubens. On the Prado Museum website, the image is described as Saturn leans over a boy into whom he sinks his teeth to devour him, while the defenseless creature attempts to kick himself free, writhing and screaming for help, and directs his anguished gaze at the viewer. So, the ancient mythologies were wild. This is from the Greek myth of Titan, adapted to the Roman name Saturn, because the Romans copied the Greek so it could also be seen as a Roman myth, but that's another subject. Anyways, Titan would eat his children, and that's where we got the idea that Zeus was all powerful because he's the guy that fought his way out of his dad's stomach, and yeah, the man has daddy issues, you can see why. But as you can see, art that is inspired by this concept doesn't exactly produce images that bring peace to mind, but we have another one just like this coming up next. At number 2, The Garden of Earthly Delights, made in the years 1490 to 1500 by Hieronymus Bosch. Bosch was a Dutch painter whose style of art is from the period of Renaissance and early Netherlandish painting. In the right panel of the complex triptych by Bosch, he depicts hell, because you can tell the Garden of Earthly Delights is kind of a nice name, but there's a hell depiction in the third triptych. The imagery throughout is reflective of the punishments of cardinal sin, and yeah, it's hellish alright. There's burning cities and landscapes, images of war, and many other torturous scenes. Honestly, with this one, if you zoom in on any number of the spots within this painting, you'll have nightmare fuel for months. There's just so much. Like, it's hard to process the amount. Just scary things in that one.